Good evening, students. In the last lecture, we have seen the functions in C programming language. We just started with the introduction part of the functions in C programming language. There we have seen the different types of functions available in C, that is built-in function and user defined function. We have also seen the advantages of using functions in C programming language. Now today, the next topic is categories of functions in C programming language. There are three categories of functions in C programming language. The first category is function with no return type and no parameter list. Second category is function with no return type and with parameter list. Third category is function with return type and with parameter list. Now we'll see all these types of functions. The first category of functions is function with no return type and no parameter list. Now, if you do not pass any parameter to the function, say, and if it do not have any return type, it means that these type of function are not going to perform any task for the user. They are just used to perform or display some messages on the screen. And these functions are not going to give any acknowledgement to the caller. Such type of functions are only used to display messages on the screen. For example, void, the function name is say display, empty bracket indicates there are no parameters to this function. In the body of the function, we have written a printf statement which print a message welcome on the screen, and we close the body of the function here. So this display function is there to print welcome message on the screen. So this is not going to perform any or processing any task into the program. So these functions are just called as do nothing function. Second category of function is called as function with no return type and with parameters. In this type of functions, this function takes parameters and performs certain tasks for the main program and never return the value to its caller. For example, void, the function name is say largest, to find the largest of two integer numbers, integer x comma integer y. Here in the body of the function we are comparing, where if x is greater than y, if this condition is true, we'll print the message on the screen that largest number equal to x, else largest number is equals to y, and we close the body of the function here. So if you notice in this function takes two integer parameters and this function is performing some task on two integer numbers, but the result of the task will be printed into the function body itself and there is no acknowledgement given to its caller in the main program. So this type of function are called as function with no return type and with parameter list. No return type is mentioned by void keyword before the function name here. Then the third category of the function is called as function with return type and with parameters. This type of functions takes parameters as well as perform certain tasks and return the result to its caller. Now we'll do some modification to the previous function. Here only one change that we did is we mentioned integer instead of void in return type, largest integer x comma integer y. In the body of the function we'll compare if x is greater than y, if this condition is true, we'll return the value of x, else we return the value of y, and we close the function here. Here the return statement is nothing but the acknowledgement given to its caller. So this function not only takes parameters but also performs certain tasks, and as well as it returns the value to its caller. It always gives acknowledgement to the caller. Note is that at a time a function can return only a single value to its caller. Every function in C programming language returns a single value to its caller. While defining the function or writing the functions in C program, there are two things we have to take care while writing the functions in C program. That is called as function prototype and function definition. Now we'll see first of all, what do you mean by function prototype? Function prototype is nothing but the declaration of the function in the program. And why we need to declare the function, user defined function? Because the user defined functions are not known to the compiler. All the user defined function must be introduced before their use to the compiler. The way we declare variables, the same way we declare functions also. The function prototype consists of return type, function name, argument list, and always it terminates with a semicolon. We have seen the definition of add function before. Now how that add function gets declared into the C program? This is the declaration line for the add function in C program. It consists of return type, it consists of function name, it consists of parameter list or argument list, and always the function prototype terminates with semicolon. Function prototype does not have the actual body of the function. This is just a declaration of the function that is to be defined later into the program. Okay. Now what do you mean by function definition in C program? The function definition consists of the following points, like it consists of return type, function name, argument list, and one extra thing that it consists of is body of the function, actual executable code of the function. And it never terminates with semicolon, the way function prototype will terminate it. Function definition never terminates with semicolon. The function add which was declared earlier can be defined in the C program like this. Integer add int x comma int y. It consists of return type, function name, argument list, and actual body of the function. This opening and closing bracket consist of actual body of the function, the actual executable code of the function. So we write the code which perform the addition of two integers here. So return x plus y is the actual code for this function. So this way we define functions in C programming language. So a question may be asked in your examination on writing the difference between function prototype and function definition for 5 marks. I will see the first program using functions in C programming language. Write a program to add two numbers using function. So we'll start with the header files, hash include stdio.h and then hash include conio.h. We write the main program line void main. This will open the main program, open curly bracket. Then we declare the function before we write the actual code of the function. Okay. So this is the function prototype or function declaration of the add function. Integer add in bracket int comma int semicolon. Then we need two variables in this program to perform addition of two numbers. So integer a comma b we declare it as integer. Clear screen will clear the screen. Then we prompt a message to the user to enter the values of two numbers a and b. The scanf statement will read the values in variable a and variable b. And the next line, here we are just calling that add function. Addition of two numbers equal to percentage d comma add a comma b. So it means that here a and b are the actual parameters of the function, and the add function gets called. From this line the compiler jumps to the actual function definition in the program. So here the function gets defined outside the main program. Integer add int x comma int y, and here this returns the addition of two numbers, that is x plus y. So this is a simple definition of an add function. Correct. It calculates that addition of two numbers and the return statement returns the result to the same line where it gets called in the main program. So this way it prints the addition of two numbers. Now consider the user entered say values 5 and 7 in variable A and B respectively. That values gets first copied into X, A value gets copied into X and B value gets copied into Y. So X value becomes 5, Y value becomes 7 and the return statement will return 5 plus 7 that is 12 and that 12 gets printed here in the printf line in the main program. So addition equals to 12. So this way function programming works. Now can we call the add function one more time into the main program? We can call the same add function n number of times into the main program. It means that the addition function code need not have to be written again and again. This way it saves our time and space in the main program. Now if you have any doubt in this program, you can ask me how the function gets called and how the function call function gets going to return the result to the main program. So if you have any doubt, please ask me on this program. Okay, there are no doubts. Thank you for watching the video.